Hey there, folks. This is David on David's Brain. Welcome to the finale of our Let's Play of Thomas Was Alone for the PS4. Please be sure to like, share, subscribe, comment, ring the bell, and contribute to my Patreon. Link's in the description at the bottom. And yeah, let's see. Last time, Thomas managed to find everybody, and now they have a new plan to basically find the creation matrix and, well, basically create new Autobots and Decepticons or something like that. yeah, well, the Transformers reference and, yeah, the Creation Matrix and whatnot. Yeah, anyways, so, yeah, Save apparently achieved some enlightenment or something like that for AI, and now there's a new gray AI to play with. So let's find out who this guy is. Alright, so gray, nondescript. Kind of looks like John. Yeah, about as long as John, but Long John. Oh god, is that why they named the long one John?
Gray felt something change beneath his feet. Something had shifted. The shape in front of him hinted at a possibility.
Oh, so his name actually is Gray? Okay.
He couldn't do that before.
So we can float just like Clara? Oh, there's a new one now.
Settled here. They'd not seen another AI for many cycles, and she liked it that way.
Alright, so there's a
Sam leap into the shifter with fear.
So which one's Joe and which one's Sam? Alright, so what is happening here?
Gray couldn't work it out. Why was the world letting him do this? It was dumb. It was awesome, obviously, but why? They seemed to be leading him up. Up and to the right.
And Gray can't jump now for some reason.
Sam would stop. This was just like the time with the pixel clouds. They hadn't seen any for a while. He was always running off like this. Sam was sorry, and he tried to calm Joe down. He couldn't explain why he felt this way. He just knew that there was somewhere else he should be. Thank you. whisper to the shifters.
Alright, so now there's Paul.
They had not occurred randomly. They had been created. The shifters had been placed in the world by the architects, AIs who sacrificed themselves to fuel their escape.
Wait.
It was an outer world, a world beyond the confines of their universe. Up and to the right.
There we go.
To like her newfound abilities. Maybe Sam had done the right thing after all. It was getting a bit chilly though.
So wait, these shifters, they all have the abilities of the original ones from Thomas and the others. Which is seeing if I can find that last little note.
Exit. He had to be the one to get out. A whole world to himself. He had to get there before anyone else did.
Yeah, no, two out of a double jump there.
To get to the other AIs of the world, warn them about Gray.
What is
stop him?
Oh god, is Gray dangerous or something like that?
Across the gap. He waved them over. He seemed, well, nice. They helped him to the next portal.
Uh-oh. Desaturated. We evacuated the facility, cut the power lines, and cut the network lines, and locked the doors. We knew by that point what was coming. We had no idea what to expect.
Team Jump had been together for a long time. They were a machine, a well-oiled machine. They could jump like nobody's business.
Team Jump.
Thank you.
I just gotta get the distance there. Bingo.
As one.
And yet they argued like many. They missed one.
Paul bowed before the team. He begged them to help. He told them of the outer world, of the cats who couldn't spell, of the liar, Gray. Up and to the right, they answered in unison.
Oh, so these gray ones can actually survive in the water. That's new. Whee!
Sam continued moving upwards. They had to make it. Gray had told the couple he was looking for a lost friend. He'd made something up about being alone on a quest for lost allies. They had eaten it up. Thank you.
Alright, now I know what to do here. There we go. That's better, finally. Whew.
Along with their spiritual leader Paul, worked their way right. Team Jump were proud of their progress. They'd obliterated all challenges in their path. Yeah, they'd heard of individuals getting stuck on staircases or stepping stones. This did not happen to Team Jump.
Oh yeah, Team Jump sounds like a bad group of Pokemon villains.
Exit portal. He smiled to himself, trying to work out the easiest way of dispensing with his allies when the time came. Thank you. The team jumped, saw the others beyond the wall. They were doing well. Paul tried to shout a warning, but they couldn't hear him. Gray counted 5 in team jump. He could take them.
Pow, you're a rectangle. Let's see.
Good thing they left that there. Thank you.
see here. A little bit of finagling. Bingo. There we go.
Sam was worried at how silent Gray had become. He wasn't responding to Joe's questions or acknowledging them at all.
Eep. Oh, son of a...
Were they really trying to save his friends? Silent Gray had become. He wasn't responding to Joe's questions or acknowledging them at all.
Good boy. Okay, this is really just... ugh. Okay, oh, stop moving, you middle... Gray, stop moving around all over the place. Look, I know you want to stab these guys in the back, but just... I hate this level. I really hate it. There I go. Now I feel like an idiot. Alright, there we go. I got there that little... There we go, that's better. Phew.
Paul knew the path ahead wasn't safe. He told the team to wait, that he'd come get them when it was secure. Gray had to be stopped, whatever the cost.
Yeah, no, just how is Gray so freaking dangerous? He's just a gray rectangle. Ugh.
Had been separated from its allies for some time. She'd not heard the order to retreat. She was shocked by the appearance of the four aberrations below. The old one seemed to be leading the liar to an outcropping. It was within her reach. She could remove them both. The couple could wait. They weren't going anywhere. Thank you.
me see here. Well, there goes Gray.
Joe and Sam ran. They had no idea where these final portals would lead, but it had to be better than this.
Aha, there it is. Exit through the gift shop. The collection. All right, now all that's left to do is just get through the last portal and then we're home free. Or at least as far as completing the game goes. Thomas was not alone. Okay, so I guess that was Thomas was alone. Yeah, it was a nice, cute little game. So what was it about? A bunch of, I'm guessing it was like a bunch of AI attaining sentience and sapience and escaping into the outside world. So, oh god, it's basically Sword Art Online Alicization. Although thankfully without Jesus Kun interfering. Ugh. But yeah, not a bad little platformer. Oh yeah, definitely interesting, definitely a little bit challenging, but hey. Alright, so yeah, that's it for Thomas Was Alone, and I know there's some DLC for it, but maybe I'll consider giving it a look through. But, we'll see. Till next time. Well, I got another little Let's Play in the works, so, yeah. Till next time, folks. This is David on David's Brain. See you when I see ya. Bye-bye!